Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Usma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 22nd of January. PM Modi interacts with vaccine beneficiaries, says India self-reliant in COVID-19 vaccination. Pakistan files FIR against Sindhi leaders for hailing Indian Prime Minister during pro-freedom rally. And Afghans call on US President Biden to bring peace through political pressure. And now for all the details. As India marches ahead in the COVID-19 vaccination drive, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday interacted virtually with COVID-19 vaccine beneficiaries and vaccinators in northern Varanasi city, his parliamentary constituency. Modi said India is completely self-reliant in COVID-19 vaccination and is also helping other countries. The largest vaccination drive in the world has so far covered more than 1 million people.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi interacted with some vaccine beneficiaries from his parliamentary constituency Varanasi in northern Uttar Pradesh state on Friday, the seventh day of the country's massive inoculation campaign. The largest vaccination drive in the world has covered more than 1 million people so far, but also seen some hiccups like refusal to take the shots over worries of potential side effects. Interacting with beneficiaries and vaccinators through video conferencing, Modi talked about two vaccines and said India is completely self-reliant in COVID-19 vaccination.
Aaj desh ki taiyari aisi hai ki desh ke kone kone tak vaccine tezi se pahunch rahi hai aur aaj duniya ki is sabse badi zarurat ko lekar भारत पूरी तरह से आत्मनिर्भर है इतना ही नहीं भारत अनेकों देशों की मदद भी कर रहा है
India has already sent consignment of Serum Institute of India's Covishield vaccine doses to its neighbors Nepal Bhutan Myanmar Bangladesh Maldives and a few others India's drug regulator has given restricted emergency use approval to two vaccines Covishield developed by Oxford University and pharmaceutical firm AstraZeneca and manufactured by Serum Institute of India and Covaxin which has been indigenously developed by Bharat Biotech.
India's ambassador to the United Nations T.S. Tirumurthy on Thursday slammed Pakistan for being one of the co-sponsors of a UN resolution to safeguard religious sites even as Pakistani authorities remained mute spectators. As a mob vandalized a historic Hindu temple in the country last month.
India on Thursday slammed Pakistan for being one of the co-sponsors of United Nations resolution on promoting a culture of peace and tolerance to safeguard religious sites, even as Pakistani authorities remained mute spectators as a mob vandalized a historic Hindu temple in the country last month. India's permanent representative to the United Nations, Ambassador T.S. Tirumurthy, said the resolution cannot be a smokescreen for countries like Pakistan to hide behind. In a statement, Tirumurthy said it is a matter of great irony that the country where the most recent attack and demolition of Hindu temple took place in a series of such attacks and where the rights of minorities are being emasculated is one of the co-sponsors of the resolution. The century-old Hindu temple in Karak town in Pakistan's Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province was set ablaze and vandalized by a mob last December, allegedly with explicit support and connivance with law enforcement agencies. Only after widespread global condemnation, Pakistan's Supreme Court took cognizance and ordered reconstruction of the temple. This is not the first time. Pakistan has long been condemned internationally for discriminating against its religious minorities, which is manifested in various forms, including targeted violence, draconian blasphemy laws, curbs on practicing religion, and forced conversion to Islam.
In news from Pakistan, as the number of coronavirus cases in Pakistan is declining, convincing the general public that the pandemic is still a threat to be worried about has become a challenge in the country. Officials worry complacency could undo that good fortune as an economic divide emerges between the public when it comes to who is remaining vigilant.
At a time when Pakistan is reporting the number of COVID-19 cases far lower than the officials had feared, restrictions to curb the pandemic, dubbed standard operating procedures, are being rarely followed in the country. Officials worry complacency could undo that good fortune as an economic divide emerges between the public when it comes to who is remaining vigilant. Some 57% of Pakistanis say the virus threat is exaggerated, and 42% say it's a foreign conspiracy, according to a December 2020 poll conducted by Gallup Pakistan.
खाने पीने की चीज ज्यादा बिकती है, मास्क महंगा कौन लेता है, 10 रुपए के तक की चीज लेके क्यों ना खाओ, मास्क पहनो, तो इस वजह से खाने पीने की ज्यादा बिकती है, तो मास्क कम बिकता है, कोई इसको हम वैसे भी दे देते हैं.
Yes, I think there is definitely an economic issue, and there is definitely a class difference which we can see in the implementation of COVID SOPs. Generally, the people of the upper classes or the upper middle classes or the middle classes, they are somehow implementing the COVID SOPs. But if you see the people who are from the lowest strata, for them implementation of SOPs is almost impossible. And for us, it is also a huge challenge. For example, if we take the owners of these public transport vehicles, very poor people travel on these vehicles, and therefore imposing and implementing COVID SOPs inside those vehicles has always been a challenge.
This comes as Pakistan is expected to receive the first shipment of the COVID-19 vaccine from China by January 31, Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi has informed. The Foreign Minister lauded the COVID-19 patients for their courage in the fight against the deadly virus on Thursday and said Pakistan successfully fought the pandemic.
Moving on. Pakistani authorities have filed a complaint against Sindhi nationalist leaders Shafi Burfat, Altaf Hussain and 70 other activists for raising anti-Pakistan slogans and hailing Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi during a pro-freedom rally in Sindh this past weekend.
The Pakistani authorities have filed FIR or First Information Report against Sindhi nationalist leader Shafi Burfat, MQM Chief Altaf Hussain and 70 other activists for hailing Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi during a pro-freedom rally in Sindh this past weekend. Shafi Burfat, the chairman of GSN Mutahida Mehz, said during the massive anti-Pakistan rally organized by his Sindhi Nationalist Party, protesters carried placards of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and several other world leaders to seek their intervention for their struggle for a separate homeland for Sindhis. But name of only Indian PM Modi has been mentioned in the FIR, which shows Pakistan's hatred towards India and the people of Sindh.
Aur digar rehnumaon ke poster aur placards jo thi tasveerein wo jasmam ki rally mein uthai gayi, lekin FIR mein naam sirf Narendra Modi ji ka aata hai. इससे साबित होता है कि पाकिस्तानी रियासत हिंदुस्तान भारत दुश्मनी और सिंध दुश्मनी में कितना जो है वो आगे निकल चुकी है.
There are several nationalist parties in Sindh who advocate for a free Sindh nation, calling Pakistan an occupier that continues to exploit their resources. Sindhi activists have long been requesting the international community to take notice of crackdown and atrocities by the Pakistani state and its security forces against innocent Sindhis for raising their voices.
In news from Afghanistan, as no significant progress has been made over the past 9 days between the Afghan government negotiators and the Taliban about the agenda of peace talks, Afghans have expressed some optimism following Joe Biden's inauguration and called on the United States' new president to put pressure on the warring sides to make peace in Afghanistan. This comes at a time when rising violence has complicated US-brokered peace talks taking place in Doha as Washington withdraws troops.
Residents of Afghan capital Kabul have expressed some optimism following Joe Biden's inauguration and called on the United States' new president to put pressure on the Taliban and the Afghan government to make peace in Afghanistan. Rising violence has complicated US brokered peace talks taking place in Doha as Washington withdraws troops. The number of US troops in Afghanistan has been reduced to 2,500, the lowest level of American forces there since 2001, according to the Pentagon.
ما چیز رو نمیخوایم که تمام همه چیز به دولت افغانستان برسه. ما این رو نمیخوایم که همه منفعت‌ها به مردم به طالبان برسه. ما این رو میخوایم که از طریق گفتگوها، از طریق فشارهای لازم سیاسی، فشارهای معقول سیاسی، فشارهای غیر معقول نه، همگی به صلح وادار شود. وقتی فشارهای معقول وارد میشه به خاطر این است که مردم طالبان که دو طرف هستند، روز میشه که به می قانع میشن بالاخره هر چیزی که از راه معقول به دست آورد نتیجه درست میده. دیگه از آقای جو بایدن اینو میخوایم که از طریق فشارهای درست، فشارهای معقول سیاسی، گفتگوهای درست سیاسی با مردم افغانستان و مسائل سر افغانستان کمک.
This comes as no significant progress has been made over the past 9 days between the peace negotiators from the Afghan government and the Taliban about the agenda of the talks. While the Afghan government's team accuses the Taliban for not finalizing its agenda for the peace talks, the Taliban so far has not made an official comment about the allegation, but warned the government of severe response if any of its member-cutting jails are executed. The group said that peace process and execution cannot move together.
Moving on to news from Nepal. To highlight the need to save Mount Everest from turning into a dumping site, trash collected from the world's tallest mountain is set to be transformed into art and displayed in a nearby gallery. Products and artwork will be displayed to raise environmental awareness or sold as souvenirs, with the proceeds going to conservation of the region.
Trash collected from Mount Everest is set to be transformed into art and displayed in a nearby gallery to highlight the need to save the world's tallest mountain from turning into a dumping site. Tommy Gustafson, project director and a co-founder of the Sagarmatha Neck Center, a visitors' information center and waste upcycling facility, has said foreign and local artisans will be engaged in creating artwork from waste materials and train locals to turn trash into treasures. The center is located at an altitude of 3,780 meters at Siangboche on the main trail to Everest Base Camp, 2 days' walk from Lukla, the gateway to the mountain.
4 miles jamma garera tyaha bata museum banaune bhaneko ta euta aafema euta naulo kura tyo garna bittike yo aja badi tourism pani bitrios at the same time waste pani manage hos plus young generation harulai pani tyaha aune euta encourage milos bhanne uddeshya pani ho.
Everest was first climbed by New Zealanders Sir Edmund Hillary and Sherpa Tenzing Norgay in 1953. Nearly 4,000 people have since made 6,553 ascents.
The 15th edition of famous Toshali National Crafts Fair in eastern India, promoting the works of artisans, has begun. Weavers, artisans and sculptors from all over the country are participating in the event following COVID-19 guidelines issued by the state government.
The annual Toshali National Crafts Fair kicked off on Thursday in Bhubaneswar city of India's eastern Odisha state. The fair was inaugurated virtually by Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik. As many as 250 stalls have been set up, showcasing the best of handloom and handicrafts from across the country. While a majority of 170 stalls are exhibiting Odisha textiles and crafts, the rest 80 are from other states. All measures have been taken to ensure that COVID-19 safety guidelines are followed at the fair. Special arrangements have been made for visitors in view of the pandemic.
We to abhi abhi shuru ho raha hai. Agar hoga to bhagwan kare to acha hi hoga. Hame ummeed hai, ummeed to bahut hai ki acha hoga.
Artisans are showcasing various handicrafts including lanterns, carpets, among other decorative items. Many sculptures had made portraits, models of several gods and goddesses, with the most popular one being Lord Jagannath statues.
हम पहले भी आते थे लेकिन अब कोरोना की वजह से काम नहीं था तो इसकी वजह से हमें यहाँ आना पड़ा और हमें गवर्नमेंट ने बुलाया यहाँ की भुवनेश्वर वाली तो इन्होंने गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से हमें बुलाया गया है तो इसलिए हम सहयोग दे रहे हैं कुछ बाकी हम सामान अपना लेके आए हैं, बेच भी रहे हैं।
The fair is open for public from 2 p.m. to 9 p.m. local time and will continue till February 4.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.